Hey, it's me again. I hope you're getting sick of me and you find these videos enjoyable. Because today, we're going into role centers, but super nerd mode. The first one was just the basics. This one will be the really, really in-depth stuff. All right, now we have sort of a mountain to climb here, but let's get started out with this. If you thought the stuff we sort of figured out in the last episode was super easy and you're now a master engineer and you could build the world champion RC car, well, now it's the time to get on ground level, because yeah, it's not that easy. Role centers aren't that simple, and even after this video you still don't know how to build a world champion RC car, because role center is just a tiny portion of how the car actually works. So okay, let's start out. So before we go into anything new, I'd like to make a correction to something I said in the last episode. When more force is applied to the shocks and the shocks and the springs press the tire downwards. And that is not true. In reality, a low roll center won't give you more grip due to the pressure on the tire, but because of the fact that the force applied on the tire will be added with the delay of the suspension. So let me explain. So when the car goes into a corner and a force is applied to the center of gravity, as we went through in the last episode, the force is split between going through the linkages and going through the suspension. This happens when we have a theoretical lever. So what this would mean is, when the car would roll, instead of putting more force through the linkages that would end up straight on the tire, we would deliver that force through the suspension that would slow down the delivering of the force, and also some of the force would be eaten up by pushing the spring together as well as rolling the car. So not as much force is delivered to the tire when the roll center is lower, and also the force delivered to the tire won't be delivered as fast. Let's go through this once again and let me visualize this for you. So the car rolls. A force is applied to the center of gravity. Some of that force is transferred straight through the linkages, and this means that that force won't have any delay. It'll be straight on applied to the tire. Then some of that force would go through the suspension. What would happen is the shock would start to compress, and compressing the spring takes force, so you would lose some of that force in the progress, which would end up rolling the car. And all this time the force is being bit by bit applied to the tire. So what applying force through the suspension does is delay the effect of applying full pressure to the outside tire. Alright, one basic thing I think a lot of people don't know about or don't understand is the jacking force. The jacking force is a force that end up pulling the link upwards so that it's pulling the car up. Now this happens when a roll center is higher, and if you understood what we talked about in the last video, I sort of explained this. It's because when the roll center is higher, more of the force is transferred to the linkages, which would then cause some jacking force. Now, what this jacking force does is it tries to raise the car. So when you go into a corner, the link tries to pull the car up. Now, what ends up happening is when you have enough grip with that extra pull force from the link, you will end up having the car flip over very easily. This is why in a lot of situations, a lower roll center will work much better on higher grip. It will provide you with much more stable and a slower roll. And the car would be as edgy or such prone to flipping over because the roll center would be lower and the whole roll movement of the car will be much calmer. Now, obviously to use all that grip, you would want to have the roll center higher, but if the car would just be flipping over, there's no use for it because you just can't keep the car on the wheels. This jacking force is a huge thing in my opinion, and if something you need to remember from this video, this is something that's sort of easy to understand and know. So higher roll center, more jacking force, lower roll center, less jacking force. So when you go into a turn, the upper link would actually pull the car up. This force would be applied when the upper link is at a really steep angle. So when you go into a corner, the centrifugal force put down from here to the tire and the friction from the tire would be applied here at the bottom of the tire. Then that would mean that the tire would want to go this way. So the tire would want to angle itself like this. So on a higher grip track, obviously the friction here would be much higher. So the tire wouldn't slide. That would then mean that this force would be even stronger than on low grip. So if you go from a low grip track, your car works well, and you go to a high grip track, the whole grip rolling is because of this jacking force. This flipping the car over gets worse and worse and worse the higher you go with the roll center. This is why a lower roll center will always be better on higher grip if your car is grip rolling. Obviously, if your car isn't grip rolling, you're gonna have more grip with the higher roll center. So, okay, the key points here. The more you lower the roll center, the less this force here is, and then this force will be smaller and would pull the link less. Okay, so now that we sort of have gathered some information about how the roll centers work, so we have a basic understanding of roll centers and how they affect the roll movement of the car. Where do we actually want the roll centers, and when do you know if your roll centers are right? Well, the simple answer to this is you don't. So there isn't a specific point at which you would want the roll center to be. So you need to find a balance between a car that has a higher roll center, which would then stuck on the ruts and sort of stall your car in the corner, versus a super low roll center that would cause your car to be like a boat on the track, just rolling around super slowly and having no responses whatsoever. So you want to find sort of a sweet spot. For certain cars, it's different things. There are certain geometries, you have to do different things because you have to take into account so many other things. So there isn't just one way to fix your car and it works perfectly. You have sort of guidelines that you can follow and find the right path. So generally, I want to have the car have as much grip as possible. So you want to find a point where you can achieve the most amount of grip with roll centers so that you have enough as much corner speed as possible. What I believe is the philosophy of a car that has as little restricting forces as possible, and then you achieve the grip with your roll centers and put as much force on the tire as you can. I feel like this is the way to make the fastest car possible. I might be wrong, some people most likely will disagree, because there's lots of different philosophies of how to set up your car. Some people like to create more grip with restricting elements such as drive shaft angles or sort of scrub radiuses or toe or whatever. These are all sort of anti-geometry things. But for me, I sort of like to eliminate some of the restricting movements in the car, the restricting forces, and then create grip with the roll center. This is just how I feel about this, and there's definitely other philosophies to how to get your car to work. Alright, so now let's get into the actual thing. Tuning your car and how I would construct a setup on my car focusing on roll centers. So as we've now gone through, I've only sort of discussed roll center as a whole and the car geometry as a whole. But there's a lot of different things you can do with the car to achieve the same static roll center height. And it doesn't give you any direction if you don't know what you're doing. So for example, you could tune the upper link on your car on the tower, or your lower arm on the arm holders. Or you could tune the link on the hub or the arm on the hub. All of this would affect your roll center height. But all of these produce different type of results on track. Even though you would change the roll center the same amount, a lot of times this would produce very different results on track. So what this then means is you would need to know what you're actually doing. You can't just measure your roll centers and then put it at a single point and that's it. You have to know how you achieved that point. So I'm going to do a quick explanation of what I'm talking about here. So let's imagine we're at the track and I want to have more grip in my car. So as we spoke here before, most of the time a higher roll center will give you more grip. But let's see how we could achieve a higher roll center. So we could lower the upper link here or we could raise the arm. Both of these changes would raise the roll center, but actually only one of these would give you more grip. That would be lowering your upper link. This is because through camber gain and the jacking force, you would actually gain grip. And when you would go into a corner, the car would put more pressure into the outside tire and the jacking force would create a stiffness in the car and it would handle the corner much better. This is how the jacking force could actually help you if you're struggling with grip, instead of hurting you when your car is grip rolling.
Okay, so why is it then that if we would raise the lower arm, we would lose grip? After all, it would have the exact same impact on the roll center height. It would increase the roll center height. So the reason behind this is the fact that more of that force that is transferred through the linkages is actually transferred to the lower arm because of the design of the hub. Then if you would raise the roll center by tuning a lower arm angle, you would have a much greater impact on the initial grip on the car going around the corner. On the other hand, what the upper link would do is it would have more impact on the jacking force and the camber gain. So when you would tune the upper link angle, you would get the benefits of jacking force and the camber gain without getting so much of that added force through the linkages, which would cause more initial force added to the tire, which could break the grip of your car. When you would raise the lower arm, it would be completely opposite. You would have the disadvantage of having more force transferred initially to the tire. Now, if you have a high grip track, you could use that force and the tire wouldn't slide. But if you're struggling with grip, this would break the grip even more really suddenly. So here's why there is an actual difference with these two changes, even though the roll center height would seem completely same. But the other forces around this and the moment arms in the hub design create a very different effect on if you would tune the upper link angle instead of the lower arm angle.
This is something that you really have to take into account when you start to study these. This is just one example I have for you, but going through every single setup change and what would do corresponding to other changes would take forever. So I'll just leave you with this example. What I wanted to do with this example is to show you that it's not only about the roll center position, but also about how you construct that position of your roll center. So we have now talked about roll centers. One important part that I still haven't mentioned that I think is the very, very most important part is roll axis. Because the car doesn't have separate front and rear ends. They are connected by the chassis. And they have the same center of gravity. So it really isn't about tuning your front roll center and your rear roll center. It's about tuning them both together. The car doesn't roll around two points. It rolls around the axis which those two points create. This is the most important part about tuning your car. You can't just know your car's rear roll center and just tune that before you really know what's happening in the front end or vice versa. You really, really need to know how your car is constructed as a whole before you can start to do different things. This is a thing a lot of people sort of don't understand, and a lot of car manufacturers don't understand it either. Some car manufacturers take a front end of another car and a rear end of another car, and they have a completely different scrub radiuses, or the roll center just don't match at all. So this is something that if they somehow understood anything I've said before, they at least mess up at this part. A lot of people just make a car that's really dull in the front so that they could sort of adjust for a too aggressive rear end. Or then they make a car that has a lot of grip in the front, and then they just put way too much towing in the rear. And all of this is just counterintuitive. Everything acts against each other and makes the car really imprecise, and it makes your life harder, trust me. When you have a sort of a good understanding of what your car is as a whole and how it's acting as a whole, then tuning your car will be much more fruitful and you'll have much better results. Okay, I know these topics have been sort of really hard to explain, for me at least, and I hope I did my best, and I'll definitely come back to this video in the future when I learn more and when I sort of have got my mind around these ideas better. In the end, I hope you enjoyed watching this, and if I managed to explain this well enough, I hope you also learned something new. Anyway, that's it for roll centers. The future awaits something new. I don't know what it is yet, but either way, I hope you enjoyed this. I'll come back to you next week with a brand new topic. Until next time. Alright, I hope you liked that video. If indeed I did actually help you out, please let me know by writing a comment down below. Also, if you like my type of content, feel free to like my Facebook page as well as subscribe to my YouTube channel, and also share it with your friends in social media. Now, if you think I was wrong about something in this video, please let me know. I'll go through all the comments, and I'm really open to differing opinions, and I really want to just spark up a conversation. So, with all that, until next time.